When will COVID be over? What is the end game with COVID? Can we ever really eradicate this disease? Take a look. We are over a year into COVID-19. Over 120 million reported cases worldwide and three vaccines on the scene. Many experts say we should reach herd immunity before the end of summer. Does this mean we are on our way to eradicating the coronavirus? Is this the end game we've all been waiting for? Yale Medicine physician and researcher at Yale School of Medicine, Dr. Perry Wilson, joins us. Welcome, Doc. It's truly a pleasure.
Thanks so much. Great to be here.
Well, the question is, Dr. Wilson, will we be victorious in this fight against the coronavirus?
Yeah, I think it's time that we actually start defining what our criteria for victory are going to be. Some people who are talking about things like COVID eradication are just setting the bar, frankly, too high. But there's another whole group of people who are saying, oh, let's get coronavirus to look more like the flu, which, frankly, I think sets the bar too low.
As you're defining what's achievable and victory, I still think the question on everybody's mind is it possible to truly eradicate it, to just get rid of COVID? We don't have to think about it. We don't have to say it.
It would be great. There's a bit of a difference between eradication and elimination, at least in the medical sense. So eradication is when this virus no longer exists in its natural state in the world at all. And that is really hard to do. We've, in fact, only done it for one virus in the history of humankind, one human virus. It's smallpox. That is the only one. We're this close with polio.
That's really saying something. Yeah. Historically, there's only been one case. And I don't think the people out there listening get it. They think, oh, well, if you can do it here, polio, smallpox, whatever, you could do it here. It's not the case because all viruses are different.
That's right. And the thing about smallpox and polio, which we can get, we're this close to eradicating, is that it only lives in humans. And so if you have a good vaccine and you get the vaccine into all the humans, well, the virus has nowhere to go. With SARS-CoV-2, with the virus that causes COVID-19, it has animal hosts, right? We know that it can, you know, it lives in bats. It can get transmitted to other mammals. Even non-mammalian species can harbor COVID. You're not vaccinating all the bats, right? We're not going to be able to eradicate
it worldwide. They're not going to line up for vaccines.
They're notoriously vaccine-resistant bats.
So I'm understanding eradication is unlikely for all of the reasons you just said. Now, can you help describe what would elimination look like?
So elimination is a little bit different, which is to say there is no lower limit to the acceptable number of cases. We're essentially aiming to have no cases of coronavirus in humans, with an understanding that because of the potential to transmit from animals to humans, we're going to have occasional outbreaks. So this is a model where you think of the fire department. You know, every once in a while, there's a house fire. Someone has to come and put it out before it spreads to the rest of the neighborhood. You're never going to eradicate house fires, but you want to eliminate them as much as possible.
And that being said, how's that going to happen? Is the vaccine in place? Do we need to get everybody vaccinated? I mean, I would assume that even with a high rate of the number of people vaccinated, that you're still going to get cases.
Yeah, we actually don't have to vaccinate as many people to get the numbers down. Well, we still have to vaccinate a lot, right? So the herd immunity threshold, when we can really start driving things down, is about 70 to 75% of the population who either has to be vaccinated or get infected. We've been through a lot in this past year. There's a significant chunk that has been infected. And then, of course, the vaccination program is going faster and faster. So that's one thing that we can really, I think, make this different than flu. Get the vaccines out there. They are highly effective vaccines, and we can really drive those rates down.